My past work on stem cells, the work I've accomplished, started about 10 years ago in a place called Klamath Falls. Klamath Falls is in the USA, in the state of Oregon, where there is a lake named Upper Klamath Lake, where a very specific algae grows. Aphanizomenon Flos Aquae. Aphanizomenon Flos Aquae is an algae which is unique in the world. It is wild and only grows there. It cannot be grown and it has very special characteristics. It is the most nutritious food known to this day on our planet and contains 115 micronutrients. This algae has been well known for a very long time in the United States. And it was noted that those who ate it were never ill, or those who were quickly recovered. And one of my colleagues suggested to me, what if this algae contained elements or molecules that stimulate the production of stem cells in bone marrow? Before obtaining a whole body containing 75 trillion cells, one cell is necessary to begin with. How does this happen in mammals? An ovum, egg, is fertilized by a spermatozoon. That fertilized cell, fertilized egg, fertilized ovum, will multiply, resulting in cells qualified as totipotent. These are embryonic stem cells. This cell will multiply, divide into two cells, a parent stem cell and a daughter stem cell. These cells will also undergo multiple divisions, by two, by two, by two more, infinitely. As they multiply, they give rise to pluripotent cells. Pluripotent, very many potentials. Totipotent, all potentials. Pluripotent, very many potentials. They can multiply and differentiate into any type of biological tissue. This means that a totipotent or pluripotent cell can form the tissue of the brain, liver, pancreas, eye, stomach, intestine, all of the organs, embryonic totipotent stem cells, pluripotent adult stem cells. Adult stem cells are found in bone marrow. Naturally, every day, we produce approximately 3 million of these, each and every one of us on average. And these stem cells naturally migrate through the bone and enter the bloodstream. They migrate here and arrive in the liver. Here we see an injury in the liver. Injury means stress. The liver has a problem. What is going to happen? When the liver has a problem, and this is true of any organ, it will generate a distress signal by producing cytokines. Arrive here and are going to regenerate the liver. Then, many arrive and leave, either because the problem has been dealt with, either because there aren't enough adhesion cells present at that moment, so the stem cell will continue to circulate through the body. It arrives here, where we notice a skin problem. Well, exactly the same thing happens. Cytokines and adhesion cells. The stem cell that was here and didn't become part of the liver will therefore become part of the skin. And if instead of coming here, it had gone there, look at the intestine. Cytokines and adhesion cells, that stem cell will become part of the intestine. When it is here, its fate is undetermined. Liver, intestine, skin, it can become any. Pluripotent. So we asked for the help of Professor Orlik, working for Illinois University. And we asked him, as we cannot be both judge and jury, it's important to ask for independent expertise. Professor, is it possible for you to prove what we are stating is true? Then he conducted an experiment. He induced myocardial infarctions, heart attacks, in approximately 100 mice. Then he split those 100 mice into two groups of 50 mice. He put them back in their cages, and for the first group, he fed them their usual food. He noticed, after 27 days, in the first control group, the presence of important scar tissue on the ventricular walls, shown here in blue, a very slight regeneration of tissue, shown in red, with a 17% survival rate. In the second group of 50 mice, Professor Orlik also put them back in their cages. But this time, he added their food molecules extracted from the blue-green algae, of which we spoke about previously. That's why I briefly spoke about the blue-green algae. We isolated two molecules which were added to the food, and what happened 27 days later, after we added these two molecules to their food? The ventricular tissue was completely regenerated. Scar tissue had completely disappeared. 73% survival rate versus 17% for the control group. There is no placebo effect in animals. This major difference is therefore very real. 17% survival rate for the control group very few new blood vessels, and very slight muscle regeneration. Here, muscle tissue is completely regenerated in 27 days. How can it be proven that this was the effect of stem cells originating in the bone marrow? Professor Orlik simply introduced a dye into the bone marrow using a technique called immunofluorescence. A myocardial infarction was then induced, or any type of trauma or injury. 36 hours later, we can see that 30% of regenerative cells are fluorescent. Therefore, they must originate from the bone marrow. The cells migrate to where repairs are needed. Since we produce 3 million repair stem cells, and that this is clearly not enough, especially as we get older, and that's also why we get older. Are there any compounds in this blue-green algae that stimulate stem cell growth and production? The answer is yes. We identified two compounds that enhance stem cell production by 30%. That means that instead of having on average 3 million regenerating stem cells daily, as I mentioned previously, the count went up to 3.9 million. That was 900,000 additional regenerating stem cells per day. In 2007, I stopped working with Oregon and California team, and I went to work with Professor Paul R. Sandberg of the University of Tampa, Florida, and we added to Professor Sandberg's compounds the cell nucleus, the heart of the Aphanizomenon algae. So we developed a product called SynerStem, which you see here. It's made of bilberries, green tea, blueberries, carnosine, vitamin D3, and the cell nucleus, the heart of the Aphanizomenon algae. Only the heart of the algae, not the whole plant. The first articles on bone marrow stem cell research were published in 2002 to 2003, not embryonic stem cells. Let's now consider strokes. Used to treat strokes, stem cells from an adult brain, from bone marrow, or from an umbilical cord blood have therapeutic effects. These cells spontaneously colonize the lesion regarding type 1 or type 2 diabetes. Adult stem cells from the liver or pancreas can become pancreatic islets in the pancreas. These are what processes sugar. That's why it helps with diabetes. More scientific articles. This is not our research. It's based on research. We didn't publish these. On spinal cord injuries, adult stem cells are capable of proliferating and restoring the connection. Heart tissue damage. Adult bone marrow or muscle stem cells can repair tissue damage after myocardial infarctions. On Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, multiple sclerosis, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, fibromyalgia, and spinal muscular atrophy, Crohn's disease, lupus, cells from the bone marrow stop the disease's evolution and reduce symptoms. Adult bone marrow stem cells grow into neurons in the human brain. Bone marrow stem cells become liver, skin, or digestive tract tissues. They can become any type of biological tissue in the human body. I must emphasize, the product that we developed, SynerStem, is natural and vegetarian. It doesn't cure any disease. It is not medication. It has no therapeutic properties. You must understand that its only role is to stimulate stem cell production and migration. It is our own stem cells that heal us. I insist because it's important. This isn't a shortcut. Our product doesn't cure any disease. Today, we know that we can enhance production and multiplication of bone marrow stem cells by 80%. This allows us to almost, but not quite, double, soon, yes, but not quite yet, our self-regeneration capacity. You know, I quite like this quote from Mark Twain. They did not know it was impossible, so they did it.